What's up, guys? Addison here. Welcome back to Dark Souls 3. We have 88k. That's a lot of goddamn souls. Then touch the ignorant. Because we killed a lot of big beasts. You know what I'm saying? So look at that. Bam! Got that dex to 40. I'm pretty happy with that. I'm pretty happy with the dex set at 40. And I think we should just dump the rest of these points into vigor. That gets our health up to about 880. And that's pretty solid. I'll be happy once we get it over 1,000. Once it's over 1,000 health, I'll feel pretty damn good about our scenario. So we just banked all of our souls. And we don't have any bone charge, right? Yeah. So we're going to go back to an Orlando, and we're going to go fight Aldrich. And it's... I don't believe there to be any other thing, anything else of value in an Orlando. So for real, we're just going to beeline it right to the boss. This episode is just going to start right off with maximum level frustration. Just straight to the boss. Probably going to get beat. But hey, it is what it is. I mean, the only thing I'm truly afraid of as far as this boss goes is once she enters her second form, and she does the infinite arrow shit. Once she does that infinite arrow shit, I'm not gonna be a happy camper. But everything before that should be somewhat of a cakewalk. Do not want to be taking this fire damage up to this fight, but. Alright. That knight followed me all the way here. That knight, I heard him. I don't know if you guys can hear it. But that knight straight up followed me the whole way over here. Damn! I got hit with a big swing. So her main thing is she teleports all over the map and you gotta watch out because her, whenever she teleports, that does, like, AoE damage, so you gotta watch out for that. You missed, now your butthole's gotta get punished. It's like a gay porn. This truly is a really disgusting boss. So now she has ascended into her second form. She is now fire-based, and she leaves, like, scorched earth everywhere. Let's make sure not to get hit by all that nonsense. She's coiling up into snake form. Watch yourself. We got a large creature on our six. A large mega creature. Oh god. Oh god, it hurts, Dad! Drink that goddamn potion. She's really liking the, really liking that shooting the spell shit over and over again. He's probably heal, right? Oh, before we get slammed on. Before we get slam dunked on. Can we finish her? Oh, no! Oh, she's literally one hit. I just gotta find her and hit her. Come on, swing, Daddy, swing! There it is! Nice. We beat her at one try. Sick. Woo! Take a big swig out of the canister for that. So that's Aldrich. Not a hard boss by any means. Not super difficult. I got very fortunate that she didn't use her, if she uses her, like, she shoots her bow and arrow into the sky, and it shoots, like, 1,000 arrows, that is the only real move you gotta be real, real careful of. Because that bow and arrow move, it tracks you, like, no matter where you go, and it lasts a very, very long time. So, if you see her doing the bow and arrow shit, you just gotta book it. You just gotta run, and hope to God you don't get wombo comboed on by it. So you get the Sun Princess ring for coming up here, and this is basically an homage to Guinevere. For people who play Dark Souls 1, this is Guinevere's chamber. That's where that giant sea is where Guinevere is. She lays down at. So that's just a little throwback to this whole area. So this pretty much is Aldrich, and we're now done with this whole section of the map. Now we have to backtrack. And we prepared for it, so it's not like we gotta do some outlandish shit to go somewhere. All we're gonna do now is we need to go to the Distant Manor bonfire. Because the Distant Manor bonfire is going to lead us down into the Ithiel Dungeon. And the Ithiel Dungeon is where we're going to head to next. And to be honest, I'm not looking forward to it, because the dungeon kind of sucks. It kind of sucks, and the area that it leads into kind of sucks worse. And then it has a semi-fun boss battle, but it still sucks. So, if you remember correctly, we came down that way from the water, and now this is where we're at. So now we're going to continue downward into the dungeon itself. We got some homies just hanging out down here, contemplating their lives. Got some bitch slinging dark magic at us because he thinks it's cool. Now she's taking some swings. Oh, she went for the KO. Damn, that knocked us down. Damn, we do a lot of damage. We do a lot more damage now since the first time we came through this area. Or through, I should say, the Ithiel area. Oh, this schmuck. Oh, did we interrupt him? we interrupted him before he could do the fucking magic. That's awesome. Get fucking Spooderman'd on. We appear to have some people over here that think they can do magic because they're cool. They're cool like that. Large titanite shard. Doesn't appear to be anything else here. Alright. Now there should be an NPC summon right here. Yes. Alva, the seeker of the spunk, from the spunk metal, or whatever this dude's name is. Alva got his shit smashed by that backstab. He thought he was slick. Uh-oh. So he can swing through my shit? I hate it when that happens. Oh, he went for the two-hand. God, he tried to go for the wombo combo finisher. That's just like a fuck you arrow. That's literally all that is. Oh, gotcha. Gotcha there, big dog. So, killing him gives you the Murakurmo, which, for fans of Dark Souls 2, I mean, that was, in my opinion, one of the best great swords in the game. Or curved great swords, I should say. There wasn't a ton of them, but in terms of raw damage, that was pretty solid. So here we are at the old Ithiel Dungeon. Do I still have... Okay, I still have the torch on me. Make sure you still keep the torch on you, because the one enemies do come back here. These guys, the old zombies that spew the maggots on you, they make their glorious return here, so make sure you got that torch to get rid of any unwanted pests. So, these are the new enemies in the Ithiel dungeon, the jail keepers. The only real thing you gotta watch out for these guys is if you stay in their sightline too long, they drain your max health, and which inevitably will end up, like, killing you. So, you know, they're a pain in the ass enemy, but if you approach them the correct way, then they probably won't bother you at all. This man looked like he wanted out. He's banging his head on the wall. I felt like I'd be obliged. Now, I don't remember exactly what the mist does. I think it prevents you from, like, doing something. Oh no, we got the maggots! Get these motherfuckers off of us. Get these goddamn maggots off my body. That shit is gross, bruh. So we're gonna make our way downtown, possibly walking fast. This guy's gonna yell at us because he's rude. Is there anything over here? Nope. Get a little bit of a jumping smash on that bitch. She wasn't ready for it. So I guess katanas don't work well on these enemies, because they usually don't take that many hits. I'm just not even going to bother with these guys, because to be honest, they're pretty useless. I'm going to keep trucking right along. I feel bad for these guys. They were just hanging out in their little cell, not doing anything. And then some dude comes along and just murders them. Get those maggots off of us. Old sorcerer's hat and all that other shit. How's it going in there, bubs? You good? Yeah, you good. Oh god, he's going ham bone. He's going ham sandwich. So you get great magic shield off of him. Let's get those maggots off of us. That appears to be it for here. Now we gotta head across to the other side of the dungeon. That's one half cleared. So all of these, like, there's a bunch of cages here that are locked that you need keys for. So a lot of this area requires you to backtrack and... We'll go into that a little bit later, depending on... I probably won't, just because it's not necessarily needed. Is there anything of value over there? Fuck, I don't know. And I don't have a bow and arrow, so... Just at this point, kind of have to. Does she come after us? No, she just stands there like a bitch. Little pine resin. So you got this, like, little friendly, grotesque man. He's not an enemy to you, he won't fight you. But you can't talk to him, he's not a friendly either. He's just a neutral character. He just doesn't give a fuck. Could not give two fucks about the scenario. That opens that up. believe you need a key for that? No, you don't need a key for this. Alright, so the jailbreaker's key. So, this opens up a lot of pathways for us. So I'm gonna double back and open up all the things that I think it is. I think I know the one thing that this is for. I think this is for this. Yeah. So this is essentially a shortcut. I'll show it to you guys later on. But that is essentially a shortcut if you do happen to die in this area. Gotta move down and then beat some ass. Beat some good old jailbreaker ass. So as you can see, my health bar has been entirely drained. I am down. I have less health than I do magic. But luckily for us, your health does return very slowly. But it'll return. And once you pretty much know that you got it all back, you can just re-flask up. So here's one of those magpie enemies, but now he's an actual enemy this time. That's why I don't understand why the one that's above us is not an enemy. Because pretty much every other one you ever come across is an enemy. So I do believe that is a shortcut area. We'll have to come back to there at some other time. There we go. Just wanted to make sure that we got that little guy. Got this little Gremmy's trying to... They're basically a big Gremmy. There's like, you know, there's like the little Gremmy's. Well, these are the big Gremmy's. This guy's in here having a bad day. He won't shut the fuck up. Alright, so we're through there, and we're now out of that section of the dungeon. Little bit of bonage action. So, I don't know if you guys can see it, but it's basically... Here, let me kill this guy real quick. It's basically right up there. Is where the shortcut is. That shortcut gate that we just opened, it's basically right through that little wall right up there. Alright. Now I'm gonna flask up just in case, because we do have another mini chest here. I would prefer not to get killed by him. Oh, damn, he took over 1,000 with that last swing, that bleed damage swing. So there's an Estus shard. That'll get us up to 11 flasks. That's solid. Now I do believe we gotta deal with this scenario. These goddamn... The villagers from another world. It's like, there just happens to be a ton of them here. God, he's beating my ass like meat. He's beating the meat, which is me. Oh, a twofer. We'll take that twofer. Whoa, I didn't even see this extra guy. This dude snuck in. He's a ninja. Soul of a Weary Warrior. Then I think we go down from here. Bada boom, bada bing. And now we are here with the Mega Giant. And he has a set of problems all on his own. I'm trying to think of what the best way is down. Because ultimately what we want to do is we want to get down there to where he's at and then fight him and kill him. But the problem with that is I'm not entirely sure that I can survive that fall. Especially not because if I land and I have like low health, the rats are probably going to kill me. So that's a thing. That's a thing that I'm not happy about. So first, let's get this motherfucker's attention. God, smash us. I probably didn't think this through. Oh my god, how much health do we have? Okay. Well, that was not at all what we planned. Literally none of that was planned. But it worked out in our favor. Because now, we can say GTFO. This sends us... Where the fuck does this send us? It's a mimic? Damn, it is a mimic. Ain't that a bitch. It looks like we got him caught in the bad kid loop. What does that drop? Oh, that dropped a bunch of the arrows. Is that literally all that's here? This is pretty useless. Oh, no, this is the ladder. Is this the ladder that gets you back up to the top? Let's see where this goes. I think I've only did this area like twice. I've skipped a lot of this area every time I've did this. Which is bad, because there is a Siegfried is here, and you do not want to skip Siegfried shit. So where in the hell am I now? Okay, now I'm above him. Okay, yeah, that's the drop-down point. Alright, I got it. I mean, here's the only problem that I'm gonna have, and that's that I am very, very low on health. So, for reals, on the real deal, I probably just need to book it to the elevator that I need to get to. I really, really hope it's this way. Okay, it is this way. Bye, rats! Bye, bitches! Bye, Felicia. So this is the elevator that we needed to take. Because this is our shortcut back to, this is our shortcut back to the beginning. So, perfect. So we can go ahead and rest our fat ass down. And we can now, with full health, go attack the rat army and the giant. Alright, rat lords. I am now ready for adventure. I mean, as seemingly endless as these rats are, there are a finite number of them. So, it would actually probably be in your best interest just to just kill all the rats first. And then worry about the giant. Oh no, I hit the giant on accident. Are there more rats? Damn, there are more rats. This wasn't planned. Goddamn rats. At least the giant does help play the rats for you. Ooh, we almost got a squishinator. God, there are more rats. God damn it. Oh boy, we got real close to getting squished. We got real, real close. It's got rats! Damn it. Mr. Rats, we do not have time. There is a giant lord here. Oh, I really thought he was gonna smash us there. I thought we would have been a little fucked. Yeah, kill that fucking rat. Oh, God. Let's heal, though? Let's heal, though? There, the giant's done. Are the rats done, too? Look at all the goddamn rat bodies. Look at how many, we just slayed an entire colony of rats. Fucking an entire colony of fucking rats. Oh, there's a titanite chunk. We needed that. Alright, so I gotta get my bearings down. I gotta figure out where the fuck I'm going here. So, the person that we need to talk to at this point is... That leads to the elevator, so that means we gotta go this way. So here's our good friend Siegfried. For some reason, he's now in jail.
Pardon me, I will. But you, I've just been. Moment, I just. Mine with the king. Mine with the king.
So he basically tells you he needs a key. He needs a key to get out, obviously, because he's trapped. And I think that means we need to go up this way and up the mega ladder. Because I'm pretty sure we gotta wrap all the way around. Alright, so now we're up here. This all drops down. Let's try to get that item. Let's get this. Some lightning bolts. And drop down, get this. Crestfallen Knight. Then we go down here. This is where we got knocked off the bridge by the giant, which we got real lucky that did not end poorly. Because it really should have. Got it, now I'm getting wombo comboed by the rats. Just too many rats, man. You ever have a problem with just too many rats? I'm just swinging in the wrong direction and shit. I'm all confuculated. So before we go deal with this whole scenario, we're gonna go push past that and deal with the Mega Rats. Mega Rats down. And we're gonna go unlock the shortcut, because the shortcut is very important here. Right. So there's the dragon torso stone. I believe, isn't there something you're supposed to... I'm pretty sure you're supposed to get a emote here or some shit. I'm pretty sure. You get something. Because that leads into an area that we'll get into later on in the game. Alright, so we grab the lightning blade. The shortcut is up there. Actually, shit, we need to actually open the gate. We can't just send the elevator up there. We actually have to physically open the gate. Where the fuck is the... Hold on a minute. Is there no lever? Is there no lever that sends this thing back down? Is this the only elevator in the game that doesn't have a lever attached to it? Oh, here it is. About to say, you got me tripping. You got me tri-zipping, game. Large soul, the name is Warrior, and bada boom, bada bing. We have the shortcut open that leads to the beginning of the Ithiel dungeon. So now we can just beeline it straight here, and we're at the shortcut. So, we're pretty much good. We're pretty much here on time for this episode. The last thing I want to do is I want to go take care of the frog area and, like, that has the mimic chests in it. I'll go take care of that, and that'll tie up all the loose ends, and then we can come down here next episode and focus on this shit show. The fucking 30 jailers waiting for me. So I believe this to be double mimic chest. Okay, no, this one's a real one. The old cell key, and this is the mimic chest. Oh god, it's an upside downy chest. Oh no, he ate me, sir. Sir, he ate my bones. He jumped my bones, sir. Oh man, you guys can't see it, but I'm just shrugging my shoulders. It's not a big deal, but I'm a little upset that I died. I mean, it's not a big deal at all. I literally just run right down from the bonfire and I'm there. That will do it for this episode. I guess I'm just gonna have to I'm just gonna start with that next episode. I'll have to go get my actually. I don't know. Yeah. Well, I'll do it off recording. I'll run down there, kill all the frogs, kill that mimic that killed me, get my souls back, and then I'll be ready for the next episode. I'll tell you guys what I get from that chest. I don't think it's anything important, but if it is, I'll be sure. Whatever it is, I'll relay it to you. So I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.